Welcome everybody back again to the Joined Data Masters second semi-final. Myth Trust going up against Absolute Legends, who will advance forward to face off against MUFC in the grand final. We're going to find out over the next short moments, more possibly short. Let's jump ourselves inside the game and we will find out. Of course, it could be short because Absolute Legends won their quarterfinal in like 25 or so minutes. It's the way they love to play. They like to play aggressive, they like to push, they like to have a healing lineup, and they like to push nice and hard. Maybe they'll do it again. Maybe we're going to have ourselves a problem connecting into the game. But not that, that happened before. But yes, Absolute Legends, they are a team of aggression. Myth Trust, they've also shown themselves. They can stick it with the best. They brought down DK. DK, that game was really stretched out, like massively stretched out. A lot of farm, a lot of very standoffish kind of behavior. Myth Trust, they cannot do that. They cannot do that this time. If they do that this time, then, well, we're in a lot of trouble. Because, well, AL's not going to give him that time. We're going to jump ourselves outside of the game for just a moment, as we're going to remake the game. I don't know. I think it's, we got to remember password. And I remember the password. Sweet, awesome, great, fantastic. We have some issues. Just loading into the game for some unknown reason. It's just something which has never happened before. But ever since the last patch, there's been just a couple of bugs, which is causing some troubles. For Naga Fighting, who's actually asking me in the IRC chat, how long have I been streaming? We went live at 8 o'clock in the morning. So technically it's been 8 hours and 20 minutes for this session, and we did 11 hours or 12 hours last night, which ended about midnight, 1 o'clock in the morning-ish. And then there was VODs upload in the meantime. So we have it's been some good Dota time. If you haven't checked out the VODs for all the other matches, they are available over at joindota.com. So please do definitely check out that website. We're trying to offer as much as we can to you guys. If you want to keep up to date with anything that is Dota 2 related, you can find it at joindota. That's what it's all about. Game is launched up, we can jump ourselves in, and we can have ourselves a beautiful draft. AL will be on the Radiant side this time with the first pick. Myth Trust will be on the Dire side. So the pressure on Myth Trust. AL just betting on heroes, which they don't want to see. Myth Trust, anti-mage. It's a hero no one really wants to see. Goes late game, Invoker coming into the ban pool as well. They know AL can play it very, very nicely. And we'll see what AL roster they try and pull out this time. So Windrunner comes into the ban pool as well. So we might see a bit more of a teamfight orientated AL kind of lineup, and they don't want to take that Windrunner as the first pick. Or it could just be push. Teamfight push, we've seen it before, it can happen again. And thank you very much to the guy who says, Toby Small, something I'm not going to say on air. Maybe shave, but then how can I calm myself? With my beard. Yeah, that's right, I said that, I went there. Remaining. I went there. All right, so let's see how we're going to look as we go into the second ban for Lakels? I call it Lakels. Lakels is easy. Oh, it's going to be Prophet. Radiant team back. It's a lot of push when you have a hero like Prophet. And we saw it in the last game from AL. They're able to bring in the Prophet anywhere, just push the lane when they want to. Shadow Demon's also going to be banned out. That's just to really stop that stupid-ass control when it comes to a team fight. So both Windrunner as well as Shadow Demon being removed out. That means Broodmother's still in the pool for AL. More than likely they'll take it. Enchantress is also still in the pool as well. And if Lakels wants to ban out something, that's probably going to be high up on the priority list to get taken out. Thank you very much for Destruction saying I look better clean shaven. I kind of like looking like this. Lakels really doesn't know what else to ban out, and they're going to take the chin. Oh, please give me a pudge. Please give me a pudge. All I would like for is a hooking pudge. That'd be beautiful. Ancient Apparition as well as ES. Anything which can counter the team fight. Tidehunter is the answer. Venomancer is the answer as well. You want team fight? We've got team fight. A lot of level 6 dependent heroes, both AA and ES, Venom as well as Tide. And that basically means Broodmother must be banned out by Myth Trust right now. Morphling is the pickup. I like this. This is the old Myth Trust. And also, it's basically everything of Europe right now. Everyone's about Morphling. If he's not picked, he's banned. If he's not banned, he's picked. Just because he is just so freaking powerful. The stun duration was like, the cooldown on it is reduced by half. It's like 10 seconds instead of 20 now. And you get that extra stats with your morph from level 1. So that's why we do like to see Morphlings just level that up nice and early. It's the way to rock and rumble. So got a couple more picks up right now. So two more bans, sorry, not picks. Then Bleak is just like, well, yeah, she's going to ban out the Broodmother himself. Dire team ban. So just thinking about what's going to be run on the side lanes right now. Windrunner's taken out. And how else do we play? The Shadow Shaman being banned out, so mid-solos are now removing. Wondering if we will see a Beastmaster. If we do see... Oh, we won't see a double jungle, but we have seen it before with the Enigma just running that top lane. Just keeping as the what was the hero name I'm trying to look for? No, it's not coming to mind. So we'll just move on to something else. Two more bans to come out from either side. Oh, it's the brain working beautifully, like a well-oiled machine. Not really. Lashrak and Darksteer coming out in the bans. And that's just AL just like, you know what, any more team fights, it's going to annoy us. There's the Beastmaster. That was the hero that's actually coming to mind. Good mid-solo, anything that goes through BKB, so even aren't thinking about going Enigma. VS is not even picked up yet, he's not going to. There's enough support heroes on the map as it is. So unless they force the Dyna to pick that up, it's just not going to happen. That means AA would have to go as a solo. Which is actually not that bad a thing. Get his level 6 up nice and early, looking pretty nice. But Lashrak being banned as well as Shadow Shaman. They're just removing that quick push. It's a thing when you go up with a lineup which is more of a slow kind of like, I like to gank and then I can push kind of thing. That's when Lashrak really makes his own. That Diabolic Edict is just so insane for pushing so damn fast. So all you got to do is just basically get the gank and then you can take down tier 1 tower really, really fast. So if you've only got like a 10-15 second gap between when they die and the respawn time and what you can push, Edict does the job for you. That's why Lashrak is such a popular pick in the European scene right now. But he's kind of like phased himself in out. Actually, I think this is like one of the very few times he's made it into the ban pool. Weaver? Okay. Nightstalker. Instant counter. So we're going to see Titan Venom get some levels up pretty nicely. And that's giving me how do you even get a lane this? Is that going to be an aggressive top lane? It could be Beastmaster running as the solo top, and that would give Titan Venom a little bit more space to move. And Chen for the push, and that will give them levels pretty fast, but we'll see how they want to run it. Beastmaster or Nightstalker, both of them can run that middle, but who are they going to be up against? Morphling and Weaver. Weaver can run that side lane, but Weaver is very, very fragile. There's not a bad hero to go because there aren't a whole bunch of chaining stuns, but there are some big ones. So you get the Beastmaster Roar, and then you've also got the Silence from Nightstalker in the Void. That's going to rip a crap load of life off Weaver, then also silence him so they have some more times to right-click on him, and then Chen can chain off with the stuns, Gush, Venomancer Gale. There's a lot of options to try and bring down that Weaver. Bringing down the Morphling, however, that's going to be a little bit more difficult. And the only way they can really do that is by denying Morphling the farm. So ensure Morphling doesn't get to the point where he becomes more powerful than God. Because if that happens, well, then obviously there's some issues. So who do they want as their last one? They can already run their two supports. They've got the tank ability. They've got some good damage. They've got some maneuverability as well. Some supporting stunner is really what they want. Or they're going to go mass heal. Omni is going to be the pick. Not a bad pickup when you consider Nightstalker as well as Beastmaster have to come in close to attack. And that's when the heal can pop off, and Nightstalker's not going to enjoy that. Same with Titan. You've got three melees on the Radiant side right now. And a lot of them want to deal off that physical damage. Well, Omni Knight, he doesn't stand for that. It's going to be really, really difficult to kill off that Weaver. And then you get the Repel as well. So add the Repel towards the mix. It's going to be difficult to get those ganks off properly for AL. We'll see if it's going to work. Yeah, I think it's a misclick. It's meant to be Spirit Breaker. What? But Omni Knight comes up, so let's check it out. Mithrust. Okay, also it's the hard carry. Oh, I say semi-hard. As the Morphling. AABBAA. ABBA. I don't know if that's actually what he meant to do with ABBA. But he'll be taking the role as the Weaver. Linu, he'll be taking up the Omni Knight. That leaves TNK taking up the Ancient Apparition. And our last one, which is RSRS. I think it's the way you actually pronounce his name. He'll be taking up the Earthshaker. Meanwhile, over at AL's lineup, Godot gets to take his very, very signature hero, the Chen. Bleak will be taking up the Night Stalker. Chitan gets to take up the Tidehunter, which means that's the one they're going to put the farm on. Tidehunter's going to be it. Snoopio's the Venomance heading up towards the top lane. I kind of want to go Shame they can't see that. And Music is going to take the Beastmaster. So mid solo for the Beastmaster. And that means bottom lane, you assume it's going to be Bleak. But Bleak, generally when he plays with the AL lineup, will go into the tri lane. So it could just be Chitan solo on the bottom lane. And that'll work out fine, but he will take a fair chunk of damage from the Weaver. But that's the reason why he's a Tidehunter. Also be the reason why we see him with double gauntlet, up to 700 life already. And then the tank goes, and then you look at Weaver, he's like 434 life. Yeah! Or 435. So just a pause for the moment. So Mythtrust, I don't know if they just need a moment to try and work out where they want to go. Idman's wise to it, well, career for Riaz, as well as wards. He's forced to buy both. Really taking it for the team, but then actually got, they've got double set of wards. I don't know if they meant to do this. We've got wards up as on Ancient Apparition as well as on the Earthshaker. So we'll see if one of these guys sells it. Or if they actually just want to empty the ward bank very, very early on. And we've got double gauntlets up for the Omni Knight, so he's looking to get up that urn charge. As Weaver's going to head up towards the top lane, so Weaver's going to take the short lane. Which isn't a bad thing, so they're going to throw the aggressive tri lane towards the bottom. It's going to be Omni Knight Morphling, as well as Ancient Apparition. No, that can't be right. Ancient Apparition could be heading in towards the middle lane, looking at this lineup, or Omni Knight. Omni Knight could work if Beastmaster's going to go there, so yeah, that'd be fine. Omni Knight to solo up the middle lane. And that'll give him some good range harassment on the bottom lane with the Earthshaker to control up the lanes. AL's kind of currently hunting for a kill. At this point, they're just going to spot Weaver heading up towards that top lane. So they go, okay, well, we've got the tri lane on bottom now. So let's head our boys down there. Either that or we just try and really control their jungle. And they can do that easily. They can look for the ganks. They can dive it pretty easily. And there's no time lapse, and that's the time to kill them. Mythtrust looking for a kill. Music is not going to give it to them. All four of them. Are they going to... Yeah, they're going to catch him out here. Try and gank between the towers, or maybe not. No, Omni's going to run up straight past it and say, hey, I'm still here. And this trailing on bottom. It's not going to find anything. The Dire Wars, in fact, are blocking up Chen's creeps, but Chen doesn't care about that. Godot loves this position. I've seen him use this multiple times. Which is... quite funny because he gets vision across on the side here, but he's so blind up on the hill. And he manages to find a centaur. Oh, the luck. Of all the luck to find a centaur. Gale misses there from Snoopy. But he's just there for harassment, trying to force AA... Oh, I want to call him... I'm just going to call him Weaver. Because I can't say AABBAA. ABBA. Oh, ABBA. Yes, Nao rotating towards the middle lane. And Chen will just keep up with the farm. It's not like Enchantress where those creeps are timed. They stay alive for as long as he can keep them alive. I just keep on tanking up the damage. And he'll have another set too. There's a Wilkin down here. He is limited to how many he can take though. Enchantress is only limited by time. Oh, hello, Mib. Night Stalker's in trouble. Great ES Fissure. Blocking Bleak in place. Heal as well, so they got the extra damage. This should be the first blood. The Kree Wave is going to run on down. It's a good void. And the healing's out. Just enough life to keep him up. They're on the run, the creep wave's doing what it can. There'll be a void in a moment, and Chen's gonna send him back. The cold feet damage will be enough, though. It's not just a stun, it does a little bit of a tick damage as it goes. And Night Stalker goes down, but Godot knew exactly what he had to do and try and get himself down there to help out his teammate. And Night Stalker will TP back in towards the middle. Really not gonna be happy with the fact that happened. First blood given. And who, more importantly, who got the last? It was Ancient Apparition's tick. Like Music is having a bit of a hard time on bottom lane as well. Morphling can be pretty brutal. But that's why Music is on the short lane. It's kind of a bit of a counter to what he should really be doing on this bottom lane. Second level on Axis, which means the lane gets pushed out. And Morphling doesn't have to fight too far away. Tornado on the top lane, that's just really just to annoy Weaver. They can spot him there, and the support's going to come in through the side. So Godok just getting spotted off. ES going to look for a Fissure opening, but not really going to be there. Just harassment with the Shooky, which he can do so pretty easily. Morphling, good to see him now with the two waves as well as one in the morph. And there's the extra stats. Oh, wow, Musica doing a great job here. That's not enough damage to finish him off. But he can attack really fast. He's gone the China build, the inner beast. Putting that up to level 2 with the axes, so when he does have an opening, he can right-click nice and fast. Go, Doc. A little bit of trouble. ES Fissure. It's going to chain off as well. Nice stun. It's always a bit best thing with the cold feet. You've got to have a chaining stun with it. Nurseshaker is the one that can provide it. And Weaver can keep on going with the damage. And he's the one that got the last hit too, so farm for him. Now boost up a little bit more of his farm to get towards that Ring of Health. Now looking for Beastmaster on the bottom lane. And watch that CS and just... Actually, let's just check it out now. So 13 for 3 up against 11 for 2. So actually doing pretty well. I wasn't expecting Beastmaster to be that good. That's the axes that really helped him get the last hits, but it kind of pushes the creep wave to where it was. And then you look at the middle lane. Omni-Knight versus Bleak. 10 for 2. And Bleak is a really good last hitter. And Omni-Knight at 14 for 8. So able to get in front of him now on the top lane. Venomancer in trouble again. The stun will fly out there. Shaitan just turns around, pops off the gush. Body blocks basically the Weaver. Even though he can pop off that Shooking and run himself through. If he had the mana. But that's the problem right now. There's been so many engagements on that lane that there's only so many times you can pop off that Shooky. Twice judged. Chen now goes inside his own jungle. And you realize that ward is still up there. It's only going to be up there for another 2 minutes. Realize it's two. Where the hell's my creep camps? I've got one here. Is that all I've got? Just one? It's kind of harsh for him. Well, Morphling fights next to the tower. Which makes it a little bit easier for Beastmaster. Just pushing that lane out a little bit further. And there's that Ring of Health up for Weaver. So he's going to be quite happy. Shaitan, no level of harassment is really going to keep up with what Mythtrust can offer. Down towards the bottom lane, Musica. Waiting for this. Godot to initiate. But they've got to land this stun. There goes the Roar to start it off. Centaur stun, the nuke from Godot. And will it be enough damage? The Strength Morph is there and he keeps on getting life. 150 HP. He put everything he had into Strength. Pulling it out of Agility. And will now warp back to base. That nuke must only be... Oh, it's actually a level 2 nuke. He threw up the level 2 nuke instead of the Holy Persuasion up to level 2. So he wanted to be there for the kill. But he can hear that morph still going. I don't think he's turned it off. He's just put everything into Strength, just so he can stay on the lane. Wow, man, turn that off. That's a really annoying sound. Weaver buying up the stick, so Wand will be up for him. It's fair enough considering how much that Anchor Smash can be popped off by Shaitan. It's only 40 mana for him. That's some decent damage at level 2. 125, hell yeah, Weaver comes in close, pop that little sucker. We'll drop him down, not to mention damage reduction. Nice way of getting last hits. Nighttime is now hit. 6 minute rune spawns on top, and the run will be happening from Omni-Knight. Bleak's gonna get, and that's gonna be a bottle charge for him as well. Popping off the illusions, Bleak decides to turn around, almost fight this. There goes the Void. No silence, so he can drop that heal, and Bleak knew that was gonna happen. But he is just baiting out the mana out from Omni-Knight. And Chen, in the meantime, soaks up a little bit of XP from the middle lane. So 0-2, Omni-Knight so low on mana. And if the Centaur manages to get this stun, he knows it too, he can't get out of here safely. He knows the Godot leveled up that nuke. And because of that, he's going to be a little bit more cautious. 910 life is a decent amount of life. And it can be brought down with a Nightstalker who can dive back past the tower. So they're looking for the stun. But they need the Void to kick it off. And he's going to lose the Centaur. The tower is doing enough damage. But Bleak just stands his ground here in the middle lane. Kind of wants his last hits, but Bleak should also be a little bit more cautious. He should be out there looking for kills. Not just sitting here in the middle lane just farming up. It's not the way it runs. Oh, hello, Weaver. He's forced to shooky a little bit. Didn't want to pop off that time lapse. It's awesome at level 3 when you have no mana cost on it. But early on, 150 mana, you pull that out from your mana pool. Never want to do that. Let your ring regen up and be a little bit more cautious. It is now up for Nightstalker. He wants kills. In the bottom lane, they can do it. Get that silence up. Beastmaster Roar is up as well. It's the reason why Bleak is now on the run, but the support is here from Earthshaker. He's always that babysitting hero, saying just far enough away that he can be a support, but he also won't leech any XP off this. And in we go. Beastmaster Roar to start it. Earthshaker's now going to come down. Look for the fissure. Hits perfectly. Morphly. Getting nuked and silenced and then getting stunned. Will it be enough? No, there is no stun. The Centaur couldn't stun it. Cold feet on Musica and they will fall him back. Will it be enough time? Yes, it will be. Ensuring that Musica can live and then he'll just TP back in towards the middle lane. He's got some decent money. And he can go one-on-one with Yomi Knight. Well, actually, no. It's like Godot's running back here with Nightstalker. Invisible. Really got to give Beastmaster a little bit more openings. Like, he's used two roars right now, and none of them are converted into kills. And now Bleak's going to go again. Silence, axes, fly. Two hits is going to do the job. Void is there, and Beastmaster with the last right click. So there we go. No roar required, but Earthshaker already popped off a lot of his ability, so there was no real stuns, no real fissures. And really, Ancient Apparition didn't have that much either. And Godot's going to come in towards the middle lane, just to keep him off the line. Does not want Linu getting any form of farm, but Purification does the job. Does killing off the creep wave, and Godot's very low on mana. To the point of he can't even convert another creep. Nice Gale out from Snoopy. Just being a pain in the ass to Weaver. It's not enough to get a kill, it's just being a pain in the ass. Hello, there we go. Negative Earn Charge on TNK. And this will be a death. Two more swipes and the Earn Charge will take care of the rest. Oh, healing salve. Risky thing to pop off. You've seen your waste of 100 mana. 100 gold. And now there's that magic wand up for Nightstalker. Initiation for the top lane. ES gonna look for a fissure right now. Weaver started off with harassment. There goes the fissure. Snoopy already with a Scarab attached to him. There goes the Gush. Ravage will pop as well. Just buying time for Snoopy to TP out. And there goes the heal. Chitan, sacrificial lamb for this one. Did cost him his Ravage to do this, and he's not going to be happy about that. Gale comes back again. Snoopy not TPing all the way back to base. A TP towards that tier 1 tower. He's looking for some collateral. Time lapse has already been used, so he thought he could do that. In the meantime, too, AL's pushing out the middle lane. Aldi was throwing down there to try and stop this push. It's only going to do so much. Now Bleak finds himself a DD rune. Having the best night time of his life. Well, not the best one ever. He's had one death, but he's been involved in two kills already. And now going to run towards the top lane. Wants to try and find this Weaver. Wants to kill this Weaver. Weaver spent a lot of his money already. In fact, he spends the entire shebang. Buying up a full Vanguard. This is not going to make Nightstalker's job any easier. But there goes the first Gush. Gale as well, manages to hit, but that Shuki gives him such great movement speed to get back past that tier 1 tower. So we're going to fissure a middle lane 2 on Godot. And he'll be fine. Weaver just trying to hide away. Bleak taking up that tower a little bit too much. He's still got those Urn Shards. He's going to pop it off too. Aldi going to fly in. Hits there on Bleak, and this might be a kill for Weaver. He's got to chase it down. The Fissure going to set it up nicely. Germinate attack will do the job. Courier is here too. In fact, Weaver might even just attack the Courier. In fact, that's exactly what he's doing. One last hit. 3 HP for the Courier. Weaver's going to feel so robbed, and the Courier's going to feel so freaking lucky. Down towards the bottom lane, Beastmaster still going up with his. I'm currently going towards that hood, which is nice for him right now. It's a lot of health regen, so he can stand on the lane up against Morphling. And with those mana boosts too, he can keep on spamming up the axes. Doesn't really care if he comes too close towards that tower. That regeneration will let him stand on the lane. Hey, ulti again flying in towards the middle lane, but hits nicely. Oh, Shatter Point, but it's not going to be just there. If he needs to, he can pop off that Hand of God, but he won't need to. He'll be fine. He'll just go back inside the jungle, farm up a little bit, and come back towards the lane later. Bottom lane. Morphling getting picked off, so it must have been a Beast. Yeah, Beastmaster Roar, as well as Void and Silence. Another two Urn Charges. There's only about 30 seconds of normal time left, and oh, hello, Earthshaker. Spots him off, silences as well, but they cannot see him anymore. And the heal gives him his life back again. Healing up the invis units. They don't even know they're going to take damage. Looks like they're going to try and make the most of this last of the night time. T1 tower to bring down. Be a good 1,000 gold to get in their pockets. Aeolia's going to fly in. It's a nice Aeolia again. Hits on Musica as well as Bleak. Weaver's going to be here. Fissure will pop off. And Musica's blocked in place. Nothing more he can do but die right now. Chen's trying to pull him out, but the Morphling will wave over the top. The Troll's trying to trap up everything else, but he's going to lose all of his creeps. Weaver's just chasing them down, but in the meantime, Tyre's attacking the T1 tower, forcing the TP out, while Snoopy's getting levels up on the top lane too. So he's going to be happy with this. This is a bit of this trade. One creep goes down, they lose off Beastmaster, but these T1 towers, that's down 262. We've got 354 and 333. So AL, they're one night time away from just knocking these little suckers over, or during the daytime, they can slowly harass them and push them down. Mythos won't want to stand for this. They're going to attack that T1 tower on the bottom lane and get a little bit back. How's the towers for AL looking? They're looking pretty hunky-dory. So it's going to be a T1 trade, or maybe not. DP's going to come down. Chitan starts with a gush, and the Ursas, they can clap once, clap twice. Waveform out from Morphling, wants to go on the run. Nice Lewis coming towards the fire, popping off his ultimate so he can fight this one. Ravage will pop as well, so they can have some time to hit on Morphling. Beastmaster Roar going to hold it in place, and the Ursa is almost going to be able to clap again. It's a nice AA ulti, but it's Tidehunter with the double kill. Getting closer and closer towards that Blink Dagger. And this will be the death for T1 tower. Two heroes down, AL fight an opening. Nice Stalker with the last tip. Really making the most out of ultimate. And look at that, it's just skyrocket up. Instant 1k gold. And it's going to go higher now. Look up to 2,500 experience. We're still going the way of Mythrust. There we go, 2,000 gold. And a lot of damage done to the tier 2 tower. It's a good fissure. They're still looking to get this kill on Weaver. All he can do is just shook himself around inside the heroes. Chen wants out. Hand of God will pop, but he will die. Nothing can stop this. Weaver will catch him up. He goes in, actually, well, maybe he could deny himself on Roshan, and you can see the swing happening. Roshan was winding up for that one, but the wind-up was a little bit too long, so the denial unable to work. The Germinate attack was following. It would have been hilarious if Roshan managed to deny him in between the attacks of the Germinate. So I gotta stop calling it Germinate as well. Geminate is what it's called. Snoopy really trying to create some issues here in the middle lane. That's something that Lino can't really deal with. While these wards are up, he can't go up there and just heal himself on them. That damages the creeps. That doesn't damage the wards. Total miss for Snoopy. Hating his luck for that. But this is this continuous harassment on the middle lane that I'm talking about. Let's keep those towers going down. Bleak is now going to get killed. Nailed by the AA ulti. TP support to come in from Beastmaster. It's a little bit too late. Goes down again. Nice Stalker died very, very fast. I'm going to gank him during the daytime because during the nighttime, you'll just keep owning them up. Music now has that hood up. Getting really close to having a full pipe completed. I think I look at that tier 1 tower. That's going to give him his pipe if they get it. Chitan just anchors it up. And then they run him. Illusions can take up the majority of the damage and they might not even stop here. Actually, TP's coming in. Chitan's got Ravage in 2 seconds. Won't pop it just yet. He needs a couple more people to be guaranteed to be there. And there goes the trap up. Weaver's caught out. The Beastmaster Roar. The Fissure's also stalling him up. And, well, holding onto the Ravage, waiting for the Omni-Knight ulti to finish off. Now it does. Aelda's going to fly in. Can only hit Musica and also get the frosty effect to Bleak. But the damage was only done to Musica. And they're going to push down the tier 2 tower. Keeping these sentry wards placed. They want to keep very, very close tabs on Weaver. If Weaver wants to harass, then they can chain him off. There goes the Fissure again, running him through. Beastmaster is here, and they see him now. The Ravage bolts off from Chitan, really just nailing the living crap out of the Weaver. Venomancer gets the ultimate off too. Ulminate comes in. It's a nice little heal off next to Musica, but Godot, his heal is bigger, his heal is better. It's called the Hand of God. Ancient Apparition's also called out. Nice Stalker gets the last hit in that one with the Yearn Charge. Chitan helping out with the Anchor Smash, but 3 euros down for Mythrust. In the meantime, Morphling pushing out that top lane. Takes out the tier 1 town, but they've lost a tier 1 and probably going to lose a tier 2 right now as well. Even that buckler going off. There goes the tier 2. Dire's middle tower has fallen. And they'll rotate down towards the bottom lane. They have more than enough damage to bring this thing down. Even though it's not night time, they've still got a lot. Thanks. There's the urn charge for Godot, and he walks in range of the tower. Smooth. Cancels urn charge. Is that the mech? Yeah, that's a full-on mech. So next team fight, AL is going to have even more heal. And the Australians looking solid as ever. Up to 5,000 gold advantage and bringing the XP back in their favor for the first time in this game. Up to 750 their way. They lose a little bit out in that tower on the top. That's why that gold grab didn't keep going straight up. It's got that little bit of a downer just at the top of it. Oh, hello, Invis Rune. They want to go for the Ancient Apparition. Oh, hello, Bleak just stops and doesn't let off the Void. The Fissure is what flew out. And Invis Rune now for Bleak. Beastmaster's got to be careful. They probably really want to initiate on him, but if they do so, they kind of know there's going to be a lot of AL support right behind the back hill. Snoopy's also finished up his drums. So more movement speed for AL to try and dive back past these towers. Get past the tower so they can really focus on getting these heroes down. Tier 1 tower, Magic is going to try and hold this. And the Tier 1 towers for AL are pretty injured. The tower advantage could be switched around pretty fast here by Mythtrust. That's still a long way to go to catch up on the gold graph. So got Bleak. As well as Lakel's getting silenced and voided up. Courier's here as well. And look at the strength morph straight up. He hasn't cancelled it up yet either. Still got it on auto. In the meantime, Beastmaster gets a kill. Gets killed in the bottom lane. An Ancient Apparition ultimate. Teaming out with what must have been an Omni Knight heal. Oh, Weaver dealing off some damage. Yeah, we got Wave as well as... Yeah, definitely Weaver dealing off some damage. Bottom lane. Chitan's going to ravage up. He's going to catch all four in it right now. Coming in. Double TP is going to buy time. Great Anchor Smash as well. Holding the Ancient Apparition in place. Fissure will drop. That's only going to mean a little bit more room to move around. Urshaker drops down the ultimate. Not enough damage when the Hand of God as well as the mech pops off from the Chen. And there's just too many heroes of Mythtrust going to go down. Godot might actually die this Scarab. He's got to get rid of this little sucker. Omni Knight will go down. Weaver gets the kill. And we'll be able to run back out again. But the T2 tower will go down the bottom lane. 3-for-1 trade. Chen was the one to go down. And the Mana Boots can be there. Tide also has enough to complete up his own hood if he wants it. And they're going to find Weaver. He's going to come out of that Shuki at the wrong time. So the Gush will go off, and Nine Stalk is just like, hey, we can do this. No, we can't. He goes Invis. There goes the Tier 2 tower. Aldi flies on down Snoopy. He gets niggled by it. And I want to retreat out now. One more Tier 2 tower for AL to go down on. Which means they currently hold the tower advantage by 4 towers. 4? Actually, they've got 4 and they've lost 1. So, 3 towers. That Tier 1 tower gone on top. That mid one is really not far behind. Same with the bottom. But they're both just without a deny range. So AL's got to be careful about when they do get to the point where you got to deny them up. Nice Stalker going to enjoy this second nighttime phase. He's almost got a BKB. That's where Mythtrust can be really, really cautious. He can hunt anybody down. Lincoln's Furiously is completed up on Morphling, but 20 minutes in. Lincoln's is pretty expensive, but... You do get to that point where it's like, Morphling, how much farm have you managed to achieve? And you check that out, and Morphling at 130 for 12. It's the 2 deaths which cripple him. He's got more farm than anybody. In fact, Weaver's also managed to clock the 100 mark. Nobody on the AL side has done that, but AL, look at the spread of money. Like, you got 13 for 1 on the Earthshaker, you got 14 for 2 on the Ancient Apparition, but then you look at the supports as well as, well, actually, yeah, Snoopy, 73 for 2, 65 for 7 on Chitan. Then Godot's got 68 for nil. a lot of even spread across all of the AL heroes, so everyone can buy up an item, which really helps out. There's the death of the tier 1 tower. They knew they couldn't deny it, and we even managed to claim that one. Interesting to see if he does go Radiant. Yeah, he will. He's got Vanguard up as well as Tread, so Radiance will be the next logical choice. Either that or Manta style, one of the two. Depends how he wants to run this. Manta would make him pretty elusive. Nice, so he can just run straight towards the top lane. He's got the BKB up done. Well, the BKB up and done. Yeah, that works. He's been really happy he spent that money too, because that's his death. He will shatter, or will he? No, he's got the speed. Stick charges keep him alive. Did he pop those after? I think he popped that after the ALT hit him. Which means, obviously, they have no effect whatsoever. And Snoopy trying to defend this top lane. Dropping down these level 4 wards. And that will cause Mythras to fall back. In the meantime, Shaitan is going to go for an Orc at the Malevolence. So silence is what's his job. Considering the hood duty has already been taken. Or is it? Beastmaster, yeah, he's already got full pipe. So we got pipe up, we got heal up. From Hand of God as well as from the mech. We've got mana boots galore for AL. So if they do push, they can keep on pushing. The only thing that's really missing right now is an Aghanim Scepter for Godot, so he can pop off his ultimate every 30 seconds. And now Roshan. Aegis Immortal would be pretty nice as well. So the Gush to start it. The Hawk is watching from Beastmaster. And looks like Mythras have realized what's going on. AA is coming down. Holding on to his ultimate for when they initiate, but it's already too late. Roshan's down. Nightstalker grabs the Aegis of the Immortal. And we're still within nine time. And with that DD rune, you're quite happy to hunt anybody. It's going to wear off pretty soon. He used the majority of it to kill off Roshan. Okay, so the guys are saying it's Refresher. Hey, the options are for both. A double Ravage will be freaking awesome. But I'm thinking about Weaver. And we'll see who's right. We'll see who is right. Mid push now coming in. It's going to go on the tier 3 tower.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And the wave is going to fly out. It latches onto the creeps, but that's all is it. Ancient Apparition brought down the bottom lane. Nice look, imagining to gank him up. Gush flying out in the Omni Knight. And now the push going on the tier 3 tower. Fortification forced to go up. Shaitan, a little bit in over his head, needs to pop off this Ravage right now. Hand of God as well as the heal as well as the pipe. Gonna buy him that time as well. He's gonna live. The Kells really want to bring it. Even the Echo Slam, but while the pipe is up, there's just no point in dropping it. This will be the death of almost all of Mythras. Ancient Apparition will respawn in a moment. Silence going out on Weaver. As Bleak forced to tank up, AL is gonna fly out. He's gonna hope he hits Bleak. It's gonna hit on Godot. Mech Charge is still on cooldown, so is the Hand of God. But there's a lot of Urn Charges out here for AL. So they will get their life back bit by bit, and it's 12 seconds on the mech. I am so gonna laugh right now if he does go for the Orchid. And I just think it was a logical thing. So battle between myself and IRC. Will it be Orchid or will it be Refresher? Musica, they had to defend up that middle lane. They already let that bottom lane get done up. And try to defend that one. Axis to fly. And Godot's also going to come in just to ensure this middle tower is either denied or killed. Oh, hello, Tidehunter. That's a long way to dive. And that's the reason why Sacred Relic is now up on the Weaver. So Radiance is there for him. I was wrong! Okay, I was wrong as a Refresher. Top lane, Snoopy's in trouble. Adaptive Striker, he at least gets the Gale off. Stick Charge as well as Drum, and it might be enough to get away. The slow is too much. And the support's coming up as well. There's some smoke and Morphling waves into it. Oh, the nuke, the Troll Trap. Beastmaster lets off the roar to kill up the Morph. He's going to be well worth it, and they're going to have to go through Strength Morph. Cold Feet trying to pop off on Snoopy, doing a fair chunk of damage. And he does have that replicant to jump to if he needs to. But Morphling, so lucky to get out of that one alive. If his support was not there, he would have been dead. And Godot's now on the run. Fissure pops off, actually blocking his own teammates off. And Bleak turns around and says, you know what, it's still nighttime, we could do this. Earthshaker trying to TP out. The Lincolns pops off for Lakels. Beastmaster wants to keep on going, should be axing up these lines right now. Ancient Apparition is getting right-clicked down. Coldfeeder's there, Bleak needs to get himself out of range for, so he can keep on attacking. Musica wants to catch up, there goes the Void. Chitan's going to come in through the rear. He does have that Ravage again, in which he will pop off. Lakels getting stunned off this. Omni-Knight will go down. He can pop the Refresher and do it all over again. There's still two heroes there. Omni-Knight will go down, Wave goes out. Godot getting harassed, there goes the Refresher. Secondary charge, Weaver, does he have time with the Fissure? He might, no, the time-lapse is on cooldown. Triple kill for the Night Stalker. And this will be the Tier 2 tower as well. And yes, for the IRC, IRC 1, Toby Nunn.
Dire's top tower is under
and the Tier 2 tower will take a fall. Chitana sits there on the front lines. AA ulti will fly out there, it's just going to slow him down. Fissure as well, but there goes the pipe. It's like, screw it, you want to deal us damage? You cannot. We will not accept that. And they're going to rotate in towards the middle. It's a better lane to go to. That tier 3 tower is a lot more injured. And then they can get the racks. Question is, can they get the racks? Weaver's up in 19 seconds. The mech charge has already popped off. Axes fly up. This one just threw up the creep wave, and they don't have their own one. So the momentum is not there for them, but they do take the tower. So if that's still worth it in the end. They'll just fall themselves back. 3k for the Beastmaster. Do we see a Blink Dagger for Musica? Aghanim Scepter straight up. Even bigger for his Roar. And Venomancer can do the same. Point Booster, he can go full Ags. What has Chen got? He's got Mech. There's Anthony flying out to him. Four star for Godot. As well as some smoke. Chitan's walking around with that cloak still. And that's just for a little bit of, there's a little bit of magic resistance on top of the Kraken. Yeah, there's Venomancer's Aghanim's. Also, Chitan spent up a fair chunk of money too. It's on the plate mail, which he put on the courier. So trying to work towards that Shiva's guard. Oh, mech. There's so much heal for Omni-Knight. It's actually quite impressive that AL is still getting these kills. I kind of want to check this one out, but I know I got to. Almost 14k. I'm hearing a Beastmaster roar right now. Weaver is so royally screwed. Catching him out inside the jungle. Do Weaver at least have the Radiance? Yeah, he does. So he at least spent the money. Looks like Morphling having a little bit of fun up on the top lane. Yasha's up for him, in fact. Close to the Manta. He's got 15 stick charges, so he'll be happy about this. Chitan just goes up to take the aggro of the creep wave. Doesn't get it all. But gets enough. Nine Stalker also with 4k gold. And, well, we're back to daytime. Interesting to see if he does go Aghanim's as well. Three sets of Aghanim's for the AL side. It's unobstructed vision for the Night Stalker. Probably not really essential for him, in fact. When you look at it, Mythtrust is very, very obvious when they're going to attack. They don't need the unobstructed vision to do that. He needs more life to push himself in. And they're going to go for this Rax. Creep waves in. Hawk is having a little bit of scout further in. Morphling's going to wave himself over. There goes the pipe up. Godot not being part of that, which he's not going to be too happy about. Beastmaster's just a little bit too far down, but the Beastmaster does have the gem. So it's very, very difficult for Weaver to find any real opening. And look at that morph going to happen in just a couple of moments. Sunset up now on Omni-Knight. Beastmaster Roar as well. Bleak, arrows will fly through, and Nighthawker does get the kill. Ravage will pop off to Chitan. He has a secondary one if he wants to go it. There goes the Refresher. Secondary Ravage. Hand of Gods already popped off. Bind time for Super. He did got his ultimate off as well. Weaver's losing a lot of life, and he decides to time-lapse it out, but still has the effect of the ultimate up. And Bleak wants to get this kill on Weaver. Really wants to get this kill on Weaver, but needs vision for it. In the end, he just pops the Ancient Apparition. Midrax will go down, AL will bring it. Melee is the one to do it, and the TP is still coming back in again. Fissure flies, they want to get the kill on Bleak. Echo Slam as well, Morphling will wave up. They do get it, but the Aegis Immortal is there. Can't send him back to base yet. And now he'll go back up. Looking at Lakels, Beastmaster roars off cooldown again. Wow, that's such a low cooldown. 50 seconds per roar. Morphling trying to strength morph himself up, but even with 3k, they still bring him down. And the pipe is up again. And they want to push in. There's a ranged barracks to bring. They want their full mid barracks gone. And then they can rotate bottom. 50 seconds without a morphling. And there is no buyback for him. He spent all his money on that Manta style. That's going to be the death of the ranged barracks. I think they're just hoping right now that someone's going to initiate. Someone exactly like the Weaver. They have no vision right now because Beastmaster is not there. Beastmaster is back in the Rosh Pit. Aeon is going to fly it down, only hitting there on Bleak. Weaver with that repel. They kind of want to go him. Shaitan's going to be sent back to base very, very wisely too. So a lot of damage being done there by the Weaver. And Bleak kind of knows this. He kind of wants that ultimate up, which he's now got. And will pop it. Just wants the range, wants the speed, and the last attack. It's not enough. 15 HP. And there goes the heal. Snoopy will TP out as well. And the Weaver wave attack will follow him. All the way back down to the base. Which means it should hit him. Well, should, but didn't. Mythtrust, one racks down. 14k gold behind, but 14k is the dead gold. That's the point when a team can turn it around completely. And it was kind of started by, what was the American team that kind of failed on that? And I'm bringing 10, that's just a replicate. Did Beastmaster use his roar for that? He might have. Well, hello, Weaver wants to go for this Musica. No, the roar was not used. He's holding on to the pipe for now. Realizing there's 3 euros down here, the wave will pop off. And Chen will just send him back. Don't waste any abilities. Let's get him back to base, heal him up, and you'll come back out again. Not dying is more important at this point. How are we looking for Bleak's items? Nighttime wearing off. Problem is that nighttime. It's good for a level 3, so it lasts for a decent amount of time. The downside of it, however, is we now go back to basically the start of the daytime. So Bleak won't want to initiate for a while. BKB and Aghanim. See, they did actually end up going Aghanim for him. Nothing like an obstructed vision, but it's very, very predictive for what Mythtrust are doing. So they can look at other things. Shaitan, seeing a little bit of trouble here with the Morphling. Chen thinking about going down. Just pops off the mech. Wants to keep Shaitan up as high as possible. Roshan's back up again now. ES buys up the Blink Dagger, so this could be a big, big timing for this Blink Dagger to come up. And to keep it a secret as long as he can. Blink in and get that big Echo Slam. Question is, how fast can they kill off Roshan? Dai were watching this, but Venomancer is actually blocking the path. There's a whole bunch of wards here. Weaver can go through that, but Omni Knight cannot. Aeoli will fly in. It's very, very nicely. Weaver's here. There we go. Blink in, Echo Slam. Fissure to follow up. Shaitan will go down. There will be no double Ravage. Pipe as well as Hand of God will pop. Earthshaker will go down in this fight. But there's already too much damage being done to AL. Snoopy being sent back to base. Weaver needs a couple more right clicks to bring him down, but does not have the time for it. And Godot now four stars himself away. In the meantime, Nightstalker is hunting the ancient apparition, who will try and TP out and will actually successfully do so. And now Nightstalker needs to run. Nutica is still here in the middle lane, and he has that roar. And Bleak putting an urn charge up on himself. Replicate will go off on him. Roar goes out, goes on the Weaver. Silence the world's void to follow it up. They need a couple more right clicks and they're gonna get it too. Will they? No, they won't. The heal from Omni Knight. They knew the time lapse was not gonna work. In fact, he wastes the time lapse. He was gonna get no more life than what he got already. Shaitana's back up again. Morphling manages to pick off the Beastmaster. And Nightstalker instantly comes back in again. They want to get this kill on Morphling. Of course you want to get a kill on Morphling. Lincoln Sphere will pop. Then goes the Silence. I do not want him waving out of here. Gush as well. Weaver Wave flies in through the rear. That's to get the kill on Snoopy. Wish they should be able to. AL is going to hit very, very nicely on all three AL heroes. There goes Snoopy. The gem is now on the ground. And they can attack on Shaitan. Shaitan pops off the first Ravage. Second one will now pop off. Refresh Roar's been used. There goes the second one. Weaver will go down. Double kill for him. Gush follows out the Omni Knight. Then Nightstalker with the BKB up. They cannot stop him. There goes the Chen Yu. Now they're going to go for the Morphling, who's just waving himself around. Roshan's still up and just above half life. And they might go in and try and finish this. 3 euros down. Weaver buys back into the game. TPing very, very fast just outside the base so he can get down towards Roshan in time. Both teams throwing whatever they've got into this pit. In the meantime, this middle lane just keeps on pressuring Mistrust. So the balance still goes the way of AL. But the last couple of fights there, you're seeing just coming off a little bit on the Mistrust side of things, and with those kills, it should be a little bit better for the... Well, actually, it's the same. XP is basically the same. Let's check out our individual heroes. Who's got the most as far as gold per minute? It's pretty close between the Nightstalker and the Morphling. 394 to 393. Insanely close. 340, 346. But this is the whole AL lineup. Everything's spread out pretty nicely, but Ancient Apparition, he's basically a walking ultimate. And there's still only a level 1 ultimate. He is not looking strong at all. And then you got the Earthshaker. He's at least managed to get his level 2 ultimate with the Blink Dagger. So he's got his items he needs. The rest of his experience and gold per minute, not really essential. We saw him before, he's a one-hit wonder, just jump in, drop the Echo Slam, and he'll die directly after. And Weaver trying to get some good farm on bottom lane. So important for him to get that as well. Needs to ensure he can live through these fights. It's already been proven that he can be brought down. Not easily, but he can be. It all comes from that Beastmaster roar. We're seeing a smoke up. Got to group everybody up into the one spot. Shatana's just a little bit too far away. Looks like Nightstalker's going to come down as well. Is there any Dire Ward? No, there's not. So there's no vision of this. And AL will smoke as a group. Musica is in smoke. And instantly, the smoke is off. Because the smoke gang was happening from Mistrust. Visual bop. And Shatana, there is no Ravage. There is no nothing. But they do get the kill on the Ancient Apparition. As I said, he's just so low and so squishy. Weaver's going to hold in place. Beastmaster Roar. Now they're going to go for Omni Knight. Pick off the support to start with. Yeah, that's going to work. Repel does not save you from that. Welcome. So AL set up for the smoke gank and do not have to travel very, very far. And now they want Roshan. And the tier 4 towers are being pressured, so it's going to force at least one hero back from Mistrust. Weaver will pop off the wave. Roshan will shrug it. So they know what's going on. Weaver might even think about trying to snipe this. The replicate from Morphling is still here. And it comes, they really want to get rid of this. They do not want Morphling jumping in on this fight. And Roshan will go down.
Roshan has fallen to the
So Aegis the Immortal going on to the Nightstalker. It's only the second one, so we don't have cheese yet. And the TP very, very smartly up towards the top lane. Realizing what Morphling is doing. Better Manza can't hold this by himself, though. And Morphling kind of knows this, so he just dives down, harasses him off a little bit. Gains himself some room to move. However, Morphling also needs to TP back out again. Where is his replicate? Or does he even have one? There goes the silence. Oh, sorry, the void. Silence was the one that popped the Lincolns, and then he jumps up a little bit further. But Nightstalker can chase this one down. He'll have a secondary void, but not quite sure what's inside the jungle. So wisely folding himself back a little bit more. Next fight, we will see the refresher orb up from Shatam. So the double Ravage will be up for that one. Defusal, really? Defusal Blade for Chen. He's getting that just to get rid of the Omniite Repel. Seems to be causing them a couple of issues, so Defusal Blade for him. All about that support. And in the meantime, Morphling is still trying to farm up. He wants to become the unstoppable force. And looks like he's going to go Skadi. So we've got Lincoln Spear to start with. Get that double ulti. And get the Skadi up. That way he can really chase down those heroes who are in the middle of nowhere. It's kind of ridiculous how many Agon Imceptors is actually on the AL side. Three of them. And Chen, I'm actually surprised he got Defusal. Like, it's fair enough for the idea of it all. But to have a double heal, or a heal every 30 seconds and have no real fear of popping that off. Gives you so much freedom. Weaver's got a TP back out again. AL's looking for a secondary Rax. Tier 2 tower. Venomance going to hold on towards this bottom. Weaver's going to do what he can. But it's this top lane which is going to push really, really hard. Shatana towards the front lines. They know they don't need the Venomancer ultimate. They've got double Shatana. And it's a good Echo Slam in. Shatana going to get the Ravage off. Refresher will pop. All heal. There goes the second one. Only hits on one hero, though. It's the Morphling who's just strength morphing out all the damage. Weaver wants to come in. He's still got that time lapse level 3 as well, so no mana cost for that one. And there goes the ultimate up from Omni Knight, keeping everybody safe from the Nightstalker. They will be forced to fall back. Bubble Ravage taken out. The Mythros going to force a yell out. The Gush pops off from Shaitan. Shaitan will be sent back doing what he can. Four stops away, but he's going to die up before that point. And this will be the death of Nightstalker. Gem will drop. And 4K gold. Well, actually, then again, Aegis is the Immortal. He'll come back up again. They'll have to do this all over again. BKB still on cooldown. Venomoth's going to come in. Going to pop the ultimate very, very nicely. On almost all the heroes, bar the Weaver. He wants the kill on the Ancient Apparition. The poison will tick it over. Omnios going to be careful as well. He's getting pretty low. Chen pulls out the Nightstalker. So they don't lose the big hero. Four staff still on cooldown. Weaver's trying to catch him. Weaver's off cooldown in 3 seconds. And they just decide, you know what, we're not going to get him. So let's fall back. So AL attempting the secondary racks, but not coming out on top of that one. Mythtrust is getting too strong on the defense. They can't hear that Venomancer ultimate from the get-go. Just was not there. They're too busy defending up against the Weaver. That's the point right now. Does AL have the strength to push in? Weaver and Morphling are getting a lot stronger. Now Sanjay, so Beastmaster go on Sanjay Yasha. It's either that or he is going to go, and I'd be very, very surprised. Oh, wow. I've been talking about that item for the, freaking entire day. Abyssal. No, actually, no. Heaven's Helmet, sorry. Might be possible. Let me get bad item as well. But really, probably just Sanjay Yasha is what he's looking at. Attack harder, attack faster, and just try and live through these fights. He already sees how much damage he takes. Well, Tadana's going to have this double combo again. And he keeps using it like that. Refresher Orb. Cooldown of 160. And then 150 on the Ravage. So basically, it comes in these spells of a double Ravage. As we see, Weaver having a little bit of fun on the bottom lane. Nightstalker's here as well. And during this night time, they've got unobstructed vision. Which means Nightstalker, if he wants to, he can initiate. And Weaver has revealed him and where he runs. And the support coming in from Omni Knight, they're going to see this coming. And Bleak does a very, very wise thing, just moving back. And in the meantime, Morphling's having some fun on the top lane with Beastmaster. Alright, so, okay, so people want to say, is it going to be Heaven's Halberd? Maybe I can win these points back against the IRC. Oh, Weaver! Locked in, but it's not going to be enough to stop him. While that Repel is up, they just cannot, and the Fusil Blade needs to be used for that, which actually was. Oh, Venomancer ultimate just pop. That doesn't hit. That Repel just keeps on popping off. They cannot keep getting rid of this, and there goes the double TP out. No Fissure, and he wasn't in range for the stun. And Morphling is now on the run. Bleak wants this. So starting with the Silence. Void will follow. Tidehunter with the Gush. Gale will follow as well. The Ravagers want to hold him in place just long enough, and they get it too. Nicely done, but in the meantime, their bottom lane is going to be brought down, and Morphling actually buys back for this. Beastmaster Roar going to pop on the Weaver. Is he going to have time? Yes, he will, because that ES Fissure. So there's the time lapse. Morphling goes in towards the middle lane to try and defend this. That's a lot of money he just spent. 1,400 for a buyback. Nightstalker's looking for a couple of stragglers. He's going to find them too. Omina instantly casts the Repel. He does not want to get stopped. He has drops his Fissure as well. Is there a 4-star from Godot? No, he's not close enough for it. And while Weaver's here, they're not quite sure they really want to go this anyway. And it is actually going to be the Heaven's Halberd. So Musica completes it. Maim, Evasion, what else do you need? Maybe the Disarm. That'll work. And we'll see it being used in the first fight. Bottom lane push towards the tier 3 tower, but it has been damaged a little bit. So is the top. There's no real good place to go. And Morphling keeps on splitting it up. We at least are going to see the Skadi coming up from Morphling. There's a lot of TPs coming back for this one. But Morphling is long gone. And AL are forced to just go back and farm. It's not by choice, really. It's just because Myth Trots are dual-pushing. And they can do it easily with their Morphling. Just keep their Replicant running up. And he can be anywhere on the map he needs to be, but that's the problem this morning. He doesn't have a Replicant. Nominate now with a Blink Dagger. So he's going to be his own initiation. He's sick of trying to heal everybody else. Just want to say, technically, that wasn't a bet. I just merely mentioned the possibility of Sanjay Yasha. So I'm going to say that that's a 2-1. That's a 2-1. We were both right in that one. Oh, the setup. Morphling trying to go with the Aeoldi setup. Has already been popped, and in comes the Nightstalker. The Replicant already starts off, so he might be able to use this for the Duke. Beastmaster lets off the Roar. Gale will then hit. Snoopy pops off the Oldman. They really want to bring down Morphling. He's hexed up as well. They need a little bit more time to bring him down. They're going to get it. No. Yes, they are.
Ye of little faith.
I thought for a moment when the pop of the water happened, he might have got off to the Replicant, but now in the bottom lane, Morphling is gone for 70 seconds. And they want to push in, but the backdoor regen is going to kick in. Weaver does deal a decent amount of damage. Now the creep wave's there. Fortifications forced to pop off. And they're going for the GG. AL are making a run for it. With Morphling down, they might be able to do this. This is a big ballsy move. And they've got a double tight ulti. Beastmaster's ultimate's up in 4 seconds. Snoopy's on the defense duties. And they're going to force, even if they don't get the GG, they're going to force Myth Trust to TP themselves back. They might be able to pick up one or two heroes right now. At least a tier 4 tower. Fitch is going to stall up Shatana as well as Bleak. In comes the Bleak. There goes the first Ravage. Secondary Ravage will pop off in just a moment. Shiva's Guard will go as well. There goes the secondary Ravage. They're going to get the kill. There goes the first one. Weaver going to go down. Illuminate will take a fall. Tier 4 tower as well. The Pipe is up. The heal was there. Everything is there. Venom even TP'd in for this fight. BTZ bought him up just for this moment. And there goes the Gush going out on the Ancient Apparition. Weaver's brought back into this. He really wants to fight it off. But all AL are doing, they're just right-clicking down the throne. Fortification will buy them some time, but not a lot of time. In comes ES again. They've got to keep right-clicking it down. There's 5 heroes to do this. They're going to kill off Weaver. They're trying to act as a distraction, but in the end, it's just throwing away his own life. And that is GG. AL will go for it, and they do take it. Morphling will disappear into the pit of lava. In fact, he's actually hovering on air. 35-16, AL do take it, but definitely Myth Trust, they had that opening on that bottom lane. But Morphling getting killed on the top lane is all it really took. He was down for the count, he spent all of his money to try and stay alive. And that spells to try and get those items up, but in the end, that spells the GG. And we will be back here with our grand final. AL have made their way through, which means now MUFC, as well as AL, will face up. It is Malaysia versus Australia. Who will come out on top? That is going to be a question we're going to have answered in a couple of moments' time. So do not go anywhere. We'll be back here with your grand final of the Joy Nerd Masters.